What do you see?
Nettle and turnips. It's all I could find.
Smells good, that.
There you go, young man.
Curse this wall. Say your thanks, but...
Thank you, ma'am.
Come on, boy.
Not half bad, boy. But be fierce. Dirty. Strike at my ball.
Eivor. Are you training the boy, or tormenting him?
One will lead to the other in time.
Eivor, well met. You received my message, and just in time. Our negotiations with the Britons have not yet begun.
I will be at your side when they do. Is there anything I should know first?
The venerable King Rodri is here. I am to deal with him directly.
Rodri is desperate for peace, ever since we captured his sniveling brother, Goriad. Sounds like a man coughing up snot. Goriad ap Mervyn.
Rodri waits at the church nearby.
Who speaks for Shropshire in these talks?
The last Elderman was killed in battle. Bishop Deolav is standing in.
Until we get this wet whelp installed. That is his father's wish.
I find the idea of leading a shire on my own quite... quite terrifying.
Don't fret until you have taken up the Elderman's title. Too many things can go wrong between now and then.
My father thinks me fit already. I shouldn't want to disappoint him.
As future Elderman, you should speak in the talks as well. But with humility. Rodri is the king and will expect to be treated as one.
Rodri will want us to get down on our knees and sniff the rosy wind blowing from his ass. I know the man.
You've met him.
Met him, fought him. He gave me this nick here. Maybe I can give him one back. Remind him some call me King Killer.
It may be you should stay behind, Eivor. That is not a recipe for a good parley.
I'd like you both to be there. To guide me, to judge my fitness.
Give us your word, then. Your blade stays in its sheath.
Eivor, don't make me laugh. We both know what my word is worth. But sure, I will let you do the talking. Probably.
Excellent. Now, to the church, I think. Our guests await. It's not far, just across the village. We've been at war with the Britons for coming on 2 years.
The Britons had the best of it. Tell me and my berserkers plowed through their ranks and chased Rodri's brother into a ditch.
That's why Rodri's talking peace now. It's thanks to Eivor.
I am going to enjoy seeing him squeal, the old oak. Not nearly as much as taking him down, though. That would seal my legacy.
Your legacy?
As King Killer. They do not all get away like Borgred did, Wolfkist.
Keep the peace, Eivor.
What has become of your preening brother?
Oh, my brother. We parted. His road is unsure.
You are better off leaving that sauntering pole in your wake.
Our Bishop Deolav and King Rodri are ensconced in the church ahead.
These houses of Christ, they are all so hard and cold.
Yet within his walls, the Christian God unites King Rodri, Bishop Deolav, and myself. On his ground, peace will be made.
Captain O'Neill, explain to the good bishop our position.
Yes, my sovereign. Bishop Deolav. We are deaf to offers of peace until Goriad is returned to us.
The king's brother
The king's brother is a moldering sack of cow dung.
You! I know your face, your stench. Eivor,
the one they call boneless. Did I not gift you that scar myself?
Ah, you did. And I mean to gift you a gash, you reeking piss pot in your fat fucking skull.
Hold, both of you. Now is not the time for keeping grudges. We're here to smooth the path to peace.
Peace, peace, peace. Not with this bag of Briton slop.
On that, we are agreed.
Now, now, calm everyone. Good faith is all I ask.
You know my demands. Until my brother Gwyriad walks free, peace between us is impossible.
He is lucky he can walk at all. Fell on his own blade, fleeing from us.
I will soon help you fall on yours.
Husband, keep your head. It is in our interest to find a way to peace, all of us.
First, my brother.
First, your head on a pike. Then the runt goes free.
Husband, no!
Enough! This is a house of God. Let us take some few minutes to gather ourselves, shall we? Eivor, to me, I do not know you well. But Jailbert believes you a steady head. We need such a one.
It may be too late. I see the crows of war gathering.
I have a hefty sum of silver. Speak to the people here. If the silver will help one bring us toward peace, offer it to them.
King Rodri.
What is it, Dane?
I wish to help you to peace.
I will not talk of peace until my brother Gwyriad is returned to me.
If you first agree to peace, he will be returned. Would a sum of silver help overleap this difficulty?
I cannot be purchased with looted silver, Dane. Stand away.
Talk, talk, talk. All we do is talk.
Talks are stalled. I fear the upshot.
Do not fret. You will be Alderman yet. Lady, let us get past the anger and find our way to an agreement. What is your husband's greatest concern?
The royal treasury has been depleted by the war. This brings immense strain to Rodri and his every decision.
If I could provide a boon of silver, would that guide your husband away from war?
A replenished treasury would certainly help my husband come to peace.
Lady Angharad, take this silver. Do what you can to calm your husband.
I shall. The Kingdom of Gwynedd thanks you.
I have spoken with everyone who matters. I should report what I know to Bishop Deolav.
We should settle this with blood, not pretty words.
Have you made progress?
The giving of silver is more difficult than I imagined. King Rodri.
Is it not plain that I do not wish to speak with you?
Ah, enough of this nonsense!
Eivor!
Lock the doors, murder that sweating pig, and have done with it.
If I could find you silver, would that quell your bitterness while we seek peace?
Peace? Is that what you think is going to happen here? I told you, I know this bastard.
Will silver quiet you?
It may not. I would have to see the silver in my hands to know for sure.
If there is any silver to be had, I will think about it.
You do that.
Eivor, my friend.
I asked around, as you suggested.
Have you come to a decision? To whom have you given this silver?
Lady Angharad will use the silver to bolster the royal treasury. That will reassure and calm Rodri.
Ah, a wise woman indeed.
Rodri, I see you mocking me! I challenge you! Single
Ivar,
combat,
no.
Now!
Boneless Ivar. Spineless, toothless, gutless. You cannot kill me! A dragon will be my death, as my seers have foretold.
And your brother. Does your destiny guard him?
Guriad!
By God Almighty, I'll...
Get him to safety. Go, quickly.
Kill the boneless one! Paint this chapel with his blood!
Oh, number
five! Ivar! What have you done?
Vikinger diplomacy! Show the fuckers who the real warriors are.
Ivar! You have scuppered the peace.
Do not be fooled by peace, boy. It is just an empty voice between axe blows.
Dear Lord, this is a massacre.
We have no choice now but to fight our way out of this.
Ah! A good test for you, boy.
Lord, forgive us.
Stay close, Chilbert. You watch my back and I will pull the knives from yours.
Dear Lord.
Stay here, where it's safest, Bishop.
Help me with this fucking door!
Thank you.
must let Bishop Dalelav know that the battle is done.
You murdered Rodri's brother, you beast! Our one chance at peace is lost.
Peace with Rodri is as likely as you dying a virgin, Bishop. It won't happen. He is too canny, too vile.
What's done is done. We must plan our next moves before the Britons regroup.
They will retreat to their great castle for certain. It's well nigh impregnable.
Then we starve them out, attack their supplies, watch them beg for death.
Dear God, more death, more war, endless refugees.
This is our only way forward, dear love. You know the territory best. How can we hurt them?
Well, for food and supplies, they stockpile cargo at Wenlacan outpost, down south of Quatford. Rodri has another secret supply line. Ask among the refugees near the river. Those who have fled from occupied villages.
Rodri's Britons will strike back long before we can.
Indeed. They will send Anir and his soldiers. They train in Wesbury, west of the ruined tower.
You do not need me to hold your hand, Eivor. I will head to Wesbury, scout around.
I know your method of scouting. It always leads to swordplay.
I am as regular as Tidewater.
I shall go with you. If only to get an honest accounting of our situation.
I will meet you both at Westbury then, once I've done some damage. Until then.
One last thing. We'll need a field before our battle's done. Try to free any captives you find. They'll swell our ranks.
they see me, this will get messy. Have a look, Sunan. I need your eyes, my friend.
Sure!
Best not to draw attention to Khan outpost. If I take the cargo here, the Britons will be weakened and want peace. Feared. More valuable than cargo. That's done. Now to track down their supply line. We will drag Rotary back to the peace table soon enough.
I give you freedom. Now you give this Shire your pike.
I will. What are you?
I died a terrible death, killed by wolves or something. Nobody read the last rites. I'm stuck in purgatory. Have a heart, wayfarer. Give a little something to help free me.
Give something?
A little offering to help a fellow out on my journey to the land of the dead.
It is rare that spirits return to the land of the living. How can I know what you say is true?
I am a talking dead man. Is that not enough for you?
What about it, Wayfarer? Are you listening? I'm a dead man. Oh, now I can rest in peace in the land of the dead and all that. You can go, Wayfarer. Go ahead. No need to stay.
Friend or foe?
Friends, peace. I was told you might know where the Britons bring in their supplies.
Are we your friends, Dane?
I would have it so.
After years of blood and gore, looting and burning, forgive us if we don't trust a Dane.
In Rodri, we share a common enemy. My only wish is to destroy his supply line and bring him to the table, begging for a truce. Once we have peace, you and your kin will no longer walk this land in wretchedness.
What you say is good sense. Very well, Dane. Here's what I know. The Britons move their goods through Dustin Quarry. See that tower to the south? That's the Hillgate remnants. Further on, you'll find the stone quarry.
And thank you.
Go!
Hya!
Show me. A stone quarry, filled with Britain supply carts. Once I burn those, we'll push Rodri to peace.
Shit!
fear.
Thank you.
Shropshire needs you.
You're dead. No.
Census. Now to Westbury, before Eivor causes more problems.
Something is wrong. Foul. Curse it. Soon.
Smell that sailboat.
I don't think so.
As Eivor, tail bat too.
Smells of distant thunder. Thor walks with us.
Eivor, Tjelbert.
Hey, Eivor. I was telling the Aetherlink here that Thor is with us this day. Our victory is assured.
So, what is your plan?
That bastard Anir commands this hamlet. So let us show these folks what happens when a village bows to the Britons. Smash it to kindling, burn it to ashes, and cut Anir's tender throat. Right, my boy?
I hope to fight well, not cruelly. The cutting of throats I leave to you.
Flames and smoke will warm Rodri's desire for peace. Anir is a lesser concern.
Peace is for suckling babes, but as you like. Oh, my blood runs hot. Let us rush in now and leave a trail of bloody kindling.
A stealthy approach might earn us more time.
Bah, I prefer sound and fury. But do as you must.
I want to go in quietly. No point bringing every armed Briton down on our heads.
Am I to stand here drooling like a village idiot waiting for your success?
Tjelbert, listen to this old man's stories and wipe his drool for him.
I am not a patient man, Eivor. Put these dogs down quietly, or I may just join you the way I did in Leicester. We will stay behind and draw runes in the dirt, but do not take long.
Best
My
grace
blood is up.
Can't win this.
should rid this place of soldiers. Less support for Rodri.
Let us get a good view of our handiwork, Chilbert. Join us, Eivor! Eivor! Did you see Chilbert fight? He is all balls now!
I give thanks for victory, and ask penance for taking lives.
Oh, Chilbert, your god bores me to death! Have a laugh! We won!
And I took no pleasure in it, Ivar.
Eivor and I were made for this, my boy. The song of swords, the blood mist, the bone crunch and baring of teeth.
Is this enough blood paid, Ivar? We've spilled enough to slake the thirst of Femini.
Why stop there?
Chilbert, I would know your mind on all this. Are you satisfied with our victory?
I believe I am. I'll need word from Rodri as soon as possible. What does he intend?
He will see the flames. He will know Westbury has been destroyed.
The bleeding puspit claims only a dragon can defeat him. We will soon put that to the test.
It is peace we want, Ivar, not revenge. If you cannot accept that, return to Repton now.
You do not know Rodri as I do, Eivor. You do not know what a slippery, lying shit he can be.
Enough talk of killing. I need a moment of calm.
You need mead.
No, Eivor. True calm. A walk in the woods to clear the air. Or fishing. Would you go fishing with me?
Fishing, huh? Looking for a warm puddle to dangle your worm in?
I saw a small pond nearby. Will you come?
We can all take a moment to allow our blood to cool.
It's just up here.
I have no fondness for fishing. Where is the sport in it? There's no chance the fish will kill me.
Here will be good. Let's fish for eel. Dale have relishes nettle soup cooked with eels fresh from the water.
I will not fish. You go ahead.
All I have are my weapons.
Eivor about our catch.
That took longer than clearing this village.
We caught some eel for a feast. The bishop should be pleased.
The simple fellow comes now.
Ah, a strange way to celebrate victory. But then again, our Christ was a fisher of souls, was he not?
Bishop, greetings. We've the makings for a delicious soup.
I'm grateful, Chaelbert, but my heart is heavy. So many homes burnt. We'll be years rebuilding.
You should have seen Chaelbert fight. He will be an elderman with sack and guts, fearsome and raw.
I should rather be fair and just, but I take the compliment.
I have sent word to the Britons. I pray King Rodri will again be open to peace, in spite of his brother's murder.
It worked in our favor. Look where we landed. Britons begging for mercy like whiny pups.
We set the village ablaze, yes. But peace is not guaranteed. And it will take another sort of skill to win it. Restraint.
Our next steps are critical, my lords. And after what happened in Quatford, it is clear to me that Eivor should lay low.
Lay low? After all I have done here, you tell me to dunk my head?
The good bishop is right, Eivor. You have a warrior's heart, not a peacemaker's.
Fuck you, Wolfkist. I know Rodri, and I know the kind of tricks he will pull. That is me warning you. If you hear me farting, that is my welcome to the bastard.
You bruised his pride, Eivor.
If you have some balm for it, by all means, share it.
His pride makes him difficult, and his anger makes him hasty. But he is not without honest feeling. I will hunt him a great boar, I think. And together we'll roast it over a fire and tell tales of war. That should please him.
Bishop, we must prepare for Rodri's arrival. Rally our men and set up a camp just here.
Peace or war will be decided, but not yet, not now. We must wait.
I loathe waiting.
It is all in God's hands. We can but pray and give thanks for this moment of rest.
The Britons have come!
The moment has ended.
This way, by the great oak!
Where is Chaelbert? He ought to be present for these talks as our future elderman.
He went hunting. For wild boar, he said.
That was quite some time ago, no?
We cannot wait. We should settle the peace now.
Lady Angharad, greetings.
We come to speak of peace.
We are gladdened to hear it. But where is your great king?
He stays at the castle at my behest. I feared his presence would inflame the cutthroat Eivor.
Rodri is king of the Britons. All promises of peace must come from his mouth.
In all things, the king and I act as one. As Lady of the Britons, I have full voice to speak for my husband and our people.
Then we accept, honored lady, your full authority.
Perhaps then, at long last, we can end this war. Our peoples have suffered enough.
And your proposal?
We shall withdraw all our soldiers to the time-honored border of our lands. We ask only that you give us some days to collect our furnishings and leave Kausto Castle. In return, you pledge to end all hostilities as of this moment.
These terms are generous. We have a truce.
Truly.
Praise be, this is well and quickly done. God go with you and your king, Lady Angharad.
I salute you all. You waged a good war. Let us now wage a lasting peace. Eivor, at the outset of our conflict, you gave me a boon of silver to ease our way to peace. As we have come to peace by another path, I return your silver in form of a small gift. Please accept this.
It is fine craftsmanship, my lady. Thank you. I wish you well.
I stand bewildered, Eivor. In the blink of an eye, years of blood and sweat are put to an end.
You have walked a difficult road, Bishop.
Chaelbert must learn the good news. Will you tell him when you see him?
I'll find him now.
Hey, Eivor.
Have you seen Tjelbert?
My brother saw him last.
Drunk as a mackerel, isn't he?
Celebrating the peace. Got started early.
Wake up!
Huh?
Where is Tjelbert?
Tjelbert?
Did none of you see Tjelbert?
Only him, Drenger. You will have to wait until he sleeps it off.
How long before he's fit to speak, would you say?
A few hours should do it. Unless you find another way to rouse him.
Must be some way I can wake this drunk. Nice nab?
That's a low thing to do to a man.
I am looking for Tjelbert.
The soft Saxon boy?
The next elderman, yes.
Said he was going hunting to bring back a feast for Ivar and the rest.
I know he went hunting, but where?
Round the mouth of a cave nearby. Follow the stream up the mountain, south of here.
That's enough to go on. Thank you. Tjelbert's bow dropped. Thank you.
paw prints and blood. Not from a boar. A wolf dragging something through the dirt. Tears of Freya. Chilbert, you live. Stay quiet. You're badly hurt. A dragon on the hilt. Guards, the Briton crest. Keep breathing, boy. You haven't got long. I will take you back to say your goodbyes. I can get you to the others. I'll go easy. Save your strength. Friends. Here, faster this way. Just breathe, Gilbert. We'll soon be there.
Eivor, what happened? No. No! You foolish boy, what did you do?
I found him deep in a cave, beset by wolves.
Eivor.
Easy, boy. Easy.
Eivor.
Get me an axe, right fucking now!
Eivor. He's gone. His god will take him as he is, axe or not.
Go, dear god, boy. And I will sing for you in Valhalla. This was no wolf. Tell me what happened.
The Britons did this. I found this blade in his chest.
A Briton's dagger. Rodri! But why?
You murdered his brother. Did you think he would let that lie so easily?
I told you he was a trickster. Peace was never his goal. He takes blood for blood.
Bishop Deolav, over here.
The walls of his fortress will not protect him. I will sheath this dagger into his lungs.
We must move fast then. Attack before Rodri can revel in his trick.
No mercy this time, Wolfkist. You spared that wet turd Leofrith. We will not spare Rodri.
I swear.
Lord above, what's happened? Chaelbert!
Murdered.
May the Lord who frees you from sin save you and raise you up.
Send the boy's body to his father, who won the Christian burial. Lady Angharad said Rotary is holed up in Kausto Castle. That may have been a lie or a tiny slip. Either way, we should find out.
There is a spot near the fortress to set up camp. We will scout it together.
A good plan. We go now.
Fine. And remember, leave Rotary to me.
Is that the other?
You men, mount up and follow me. There's work to be done. I should have known he would come for the weakest of us.
You opened a bloody wound when you killed Rotary's brother.
Anything worth doing must be paid for in blood.
In Quartford, you told me Rotary gave you that scar on your face. Is it a story worth telling?
Not worth telling, it is worth remembering. Years ago, I was headed back from the Western Isle. They have got fighters there. I had taken a bit of a beating, put me in a surly mood. I wanted blood and silver, nothing more. So, me and my Drangir sailing along the coast of Camry, see a nice spot for landing, covered in mist. We drag our ships ashore. And just then, a cry came from atop a hillock. The troll cursed Britons. The fog clears a bit. And there they are, all lined up. The biggest one calls out, "I am Rodri, king of this land. That means shit to me!" I scream back. I give my boys a nod. And we raise up our axes and charge before they take a breath. We have the numbers. But the Britons are clever. It's marshland. The bog catches our boots, sucks us to a standstill. One by one, Rodri cuts us to bits. He gets to me, lays his blade at my cheek, and gives me this nick. "Leave this land and give your people fair warning," he says. "Tell them King Rodri gave you that cut." "Hen shit," I say. Rodri laughs and lets me go.
Quite a story, Eivor. Son of Ragnar, killer of kings, conqueror of England and the West.
That sweat-sopped slug is just beyond those walls. May only be defeated by a dragon, my itching ass. He'll meet one, all right.
Send a message to your men. You can build a camp here and lay plans for a surprise attack. Ivar's men waste no time. They're eager to pay out our revenge.
I am ready.
What in the name of Loki have you done?
Called in the dragon to help me slay Rodri. Now what say you, Wolfkist? Are you ready for war?
Rally the men, Eivor. Let's have at it.
It is a good day to die.
The gate looks to be well defended.
My men are loading a cart with cauldrons of oil. We will blast right through that fucking gate.
Mm.
show yourself!
I am here, Boneless Ragnarsson. How is it you come in force when our peace has been concluded?
Do not mock us, whore son! You splattered blood on our peace with the butchery of young Chalbert!
Speak what nonsense you please, Dane. If you mean war, our defenses are sure.
Gaze upon my face, King of Crowfood, and meet the dragon that will devour you!
I see a spent old man playing at serpents.
Enough talking, Eivor.
Bring the oil cart and set the fires! When I am done with Rodri, I will tear the fat from his shanks and use it to fry our bread. Get the cart, boys!
Take this!
We will light it up in front of the gate!
Get the wagon to the gate!
Watch out!
Get behind the car!
Go back! I will watch the castle walls! We'll roll this blood!
Come on!
Holy Saint Geralt! Danes!
Help me with this!
Eivor the Boneless. You make a pitiful dragon. Old oak.
He's not dead.
No. I have something else planned. Spectacle, remember?
He's nothing now but a sad sack of flesh. Kill him and be done with it.
Oh, no. This will be good. I have something specific in mind. A place and a method. Come.
All right, let's get this over with.
Load this lump of lard onto your horse and we will go. Take care he stays alive.
Eivor, do not forget that load of rotten flesh called Rodri.
Where are we going?
An overlook I found while scouting. A view. One fit for a dying king.
There's no need for spectacle, Eivor. Let the man die with honor.
No, no, no. He must die with style.
Oh,
How are you doing, dear king? Stay with us. You must not miss what is coming. I killed King Ella, King Osbard, King Edmund, and now King Roderick. Who else can claim such a string of victories?
Just finish me.
It is not my place to interfere in this feud.
Does he breathe still?
Barely.
Rodri, are you listening? For years I wore this scar with shame. Nicked by a Briton and left alive. I tried to cover it with a beard, a cloak. But as your fame grew, I began to beam with pride. A king gave me this mark. What say you to this, Rodri? Huh? Speak up, you old bag of sweat and grease. Here we are. Bring him close. This way! Up there to the top and keep him breathing.
Finish this quickly, Eivor.
See here? A hungry blade. Now comes the dragon to feed on his favorite meal. The blood eagle.
Eivor, is this...
The birth of a blood eagle is a sight to behold, my friend. First, I slice the length of your spine.
That is a Norseman. The true essence of old heroes.
The Blood Eagle has no true meaning for Eivor. He is doing it simply to take pleasure in suffering.
Now, I pull back the flesh.
The method will always outlive the meaning. Few in time will care why this man died. But the how, that is a song for the ages. The fog between good and evil grows thick over time, but glory never fades.
There is nothing glorious here.
Life is not pretty. It is a bloody fight.
Out come the lungs, and we spread them like wings. All of Mercia can see him now.
I have seen enough.
We are not finished, Eivor. This saga we have written together, it needs an ending. Here and now.
It is ended, Eivor. I'm done with this place.
A fight to the death. You and me. If I win, I am the greatest Vikinger who ever lived. If I lose... What a tale you have to tell!
You are battle drunk, Eivor. Goodbye.
poor Chaelbert. He barely said a word.
When?
I pushed that dragon dagger into his heart.
No.
Just a soft little squeal. Then, nothing.
You sick, cursed fuckhound!
The things a man must do. The trials one must face. The friends one must betray. To achieve one's destiny. And become King Killer forevermore.
Traitor! Chaelbert was...
like a son to me! Yes! Yes! So fight me, Wolfkist, to a glorious death! This is the life, Eivor! To fight high above the world! Valhalla awaits! Have you no sense of menace? When I stab Guriad, you wince. You cower in the face of sudden drama.
I feel great.
Do you remember your first kill? Mine was a boyhood friend. He squealed like a piglet. Like Chaelbert. Hold a moment, Eivor. Let me ask you something.
Speak then, or I take your tongue.
Will you see your father in Valhalla, Wolfkist? Or is the coward in Helheim weeping tears of ice? Gold again! Bleed like Chaelbert! Valkyrie's approach. My axe, Eivor. Hand me my weapon.
Odin may have use for you, but this is more than you deserve. Do not shame him.
I hear their wings.
Carry the body to Quatford. We will say our goodbyes there. And send a message to Uber. Tell him his brother is dead.
Thank you. Is that a bottomless stomach, I see? You win if you can down it faster than me. Didn't your mummy say it was all right? There's drinking to be done!
Eivor, hello. Another dark day clouds our victory.
Bishop. Ubba.
Dead at the hands of a Briton. I cannot imagine the shame my brother felt in his final hour. Were it not for this peace...
I killed him.
You?
After peace was made, Ivar murdered Chaelbert and pinned the crime on Rotary to get another swing at him.
How do you come to know this?
He told me himself.
I am always one who desires the truth, Eivor, but this... this is a hard thing to hear. Did he die well?
He died a fighter, in all his glory.
As he wanted then. With Ivar gone, peace and quiet are now possible. That is something. I will console myself for the thought that we will meet again in Valhalla. Axe in hand.
You will.
For good or ill, he lived life by his own rules. What man can say better?
He lived his life at cross purposes. I often found him strange and his actions puzzling. But not all men are meant to be understood.
He needs a proper farewell. I will prepare a ship for his funeral pyre.
Bishop, send word to Lady Angharad. Say that her husband died by treachery, and that Eivor has paid the price for it.
As soon as I am able.
Have you heard from King Ceolwulf? I cannot imagine his grief.
He is felled by it. Still, he makes plans for this shire. I am to be elderman here. Therefore, Shiropshire declares herself your friend and ally, and will remain so for the length of my days.
I'm grateful, Bishop.
God go with you, Eivor, wherever you may lead.
Bringer of battle song. The boneless one sails into a singing glory on a flaming water steed.
Wind across the water. The battle maidens beat their wings to carry a king to Odin's hall of corpses.
Eivor gone. Shiropshire, an ally. I should confer with Randvi.
You look well.
We are allied with Shiropshire, but at a grievous cost. Young Chelbet was killed.
Yes, my scouts told me. Such a tragic death for so dubious a gain. I hope you paid his killers back in kind.
Justice was done.
Chelbet will be remembered. He was good company in the short time he was with us.
He was. I want to see the Alliance map. Tell me more about Kent.
Basim has written, claiming to have found the woman Fulke and asking for your aid. He has taken shelter at St. Hadrian's Priory.
Any news of Sigurd?
Nothing he mentioned, but if he has found the paladin Fulke, Sigurd cannot be far behind.
I will go as soon as I can.
Good. Be safe, Eivor.
Dag, Basim has brought word of Sigurd's location. We're leaving at once to find him.
Well done, Eivor. After so long, it finally occurs to you to search for our Jarl. I applaud your half-hearted effort, but I will not be joining you.
Dag, this is no joke. On the ship, now.
Someone needs to stay home and direct the affairs of the settlement. As you seem to shun this place as often as possible, it must fall to me.
If you wish to stay, so be it. But when Sigurd is back among us, we'll see what status you have among the raiders.
Say whatever makes you feel superior, Eivor. I know Sigurd will understand my decision.
Do you doubt me so completely that you will not raise an axe to save your Jarl?
A fine way of putting it, Wolf-kissed. But go, find the Jarl, bring him back. Only do not get lost along the way, as you seem to more and more these days.
This is not done, Dag. We will speak when I return.
Thank you. Yeah.
Vassim has news of Sigurd. I should find him soon.
The guards here are vigilant. Feel stronger already.
That is my point.
So you hold no stock in faith, only...
What I mean to say is, faith is paramount. Yes, for without it, Christ's sacrifice means nothing.
He died to save us, did he not? From the original sin of Adam and Eve? Yet evil persists.
Yes, evil persists, because he gave us free will.
Does a newborn babe, slain by a despot, have free will?
Yes. No, I mean, that is too simplistic.
Or the priest whose heart is torn from his chest by the wolf? Judas, who was predestined to betray the Nazarene?
Some argue Judas was used.
Do my ears deceive me, Brother Hortbert? You question the scriptures? Declare Judas an innocent? A preposterous blasphemy.
No, that is not what I said. Brother Cedric, am I not the most pious of his servants?
Out! Out!
Making new friends?
A person's tongue gives you a taste of their heart, Eivor. And such information is often useful.
And how do these sallow Christians taste?
It was only a figure of speech, Eivor. And I have tired of it already.
Is this how it must be between us?
Of course not. I'm grateful that you have come.
What happened in Mercia still puzzles me. Fulke saw something in Sigurd. A power, a legacy. What is it she wants?
Her motives are difficult to fathom, but that can come later. Let's find your brother first.
Agreed. If we do this, you'll earn the right to call me friend 10,000-fold. So, what is your plan?
We are deep in their god's heartland, a heathen and a heretic. To hunt Fulke will need a Christian snare.
Fulke is hardly a saint herself. These Christians abhor her strange ideas.
True. But unlike us, she can carry herself as one of them. She won't hide from everyone, not with a prisoner in tow.
So, where to begin?
I've made a friend, Abbot Cunibert, full of pious fire, but with ambition that far outweighs his wit.
And what does your friend Cunibert know?
Come, I will introduce you, and we'll hear the full tale together.
Have you found some peace in your time alone, Basim?
I am always at peace, and never alone. I move among the people of the world with great joy. I watch them, study them, learn from them at all times. This is our duty, the Hidden One's calling.
You know, for the first time since we've met, you sound more like you're a princess than yourself.
Surely Hytham sounds like me, if I have taught him well.
Your creed and your tenets, you mean?
That's right. And our sense of, how should I say, deep responsibility to the betterment of mankind.
That's quite an ambition. But it doesn't explain what you see in Sigurd. My brother is not so generous.
Ah, but your brother is someone special, important. And I want him to see that. I hope to show it to him.
Is this not a blessed plot? God's own country. And this Eden should be given to his servants to tend.
Abbot Cunibert. This is the Norse I spoke of.
Ah, yes. And quite a fearsome one at that.
Basim says you know the paladin Fulke.
Indeed. The Lady Fulke passed this way not more than a month ago. We talked, we drank. Very pleasant woman.
And where is she?
Eivor will be your axe, Abbot. Whether to fell a tree or hew the limbs from an enemy.
What have you promised him?
Oh, just a trifle, Eivor. A little problem I believe you can help me with.
If you know where Fulke is, do not rattle my bucket. Tell me now and we'll talk terms later.
The hot-tempered one stirs up strife, Basim. Will this rebellion-caked Dane do what I ask?
Let's cut to the point. What favor would you ask in exchange for Fulke?
Some weeks ago, our elderman in Kent was called to God. A terrible loss. King Alfred has chosen his replacement, but has not yet announced the name. I must know it. Now.
All of Kent will see soon enough which Thane has chosen. Why not wait?
I want early access. To woo him, before his exalted position is made public and every fool is at his door.
Who else knows the chosen man?
The king's emissary, sent with a letter of congratulations to the new elderman. Intercept him and bring me the news. When I know the Thane's name, we'll discuss how I might win his favor.
If we do this, how will you find Fulke? I want some kind of assurance.
Do you have ears in every church, abbey, and cathedral in Kent? Because I do. And I will find her.
And we will do the deeds too staining for a Christian soul.
This emissary, how will I find him?
Tunbridge Monastery sent word that the king's men always pass a few nights in their hospitality. Begin there.
I'll give the elderman's name. You find Fulke.
All in good time. Now, if we're done, I have business up the south coast. Falkenston has the best fish in Wessex.
Then I will find you there when the Elderman's name is mine.
Cunibert is ambitious, but well connected. We will not find Fulke without him.
I suppose we'll see. What will you do?
I'm not done playing with these Christians yet. I will see you in Falkenston.
Ah! Hyah!
Alfred's emissary spent a few days here. Someone may know where he went. Damned. Need to get on the other side.
I'm in no mood for wind belching, so choose your words well.
The king's emissary. I need to know where he went after he stayed here.
And I need to know why I've started getting boils under my armpits. Time will tell, eh?
Alfred's emissary.
Where?
Him and the bard ended up in a copse by the bridge doing Lord knows what. Sounded like they were murdering a cat.
Singing?
If you say so.
Loitering and lollygagging.
I'm looking for someone. An emissary from Alfred. Have you seen such a man?
Ooh, la-di-da. Listen to you, all high and mighty. Get away with you, you valley lily.
If you would rather feel the edge of my blade, it can be arranged.
Yeah, that I respect. Forceful, to the point. As refreshing as a summer ale.
You're a strange fish. Did you see the man or not?
I did. He was getting pie-eyed with that bard Gowan and causing quite a ruckus. They left together. See? That wasn't hard, was it?
Harder than it should have been.
There was a bard drinking with the emissary. I should find him. See if he knows anything.
Spread your wings, Sunan.
That ill-swarmed scarp can't have gone far.
You there. You alive.
Patience is a tired horse. Ploddity plod plod.
Another tottering teat sucker who can't hold his drink. Let's clear your head.
Oh! Oh, it
God's truths! Fie on you! Oh, what inferno wakes me?
Are you the tale weaver?
Gawain the dandelion. For the seeds of my stories flit upon the winds of Wessex. But why, mule, do you kick my noggin?
You and Alfred's emissary were drinking in the tavern. Tell me where he went.
Were we? I was so ale-addled. Perhaps a small and silver thing upon my palm might help me recall?
How about something long and sharp in your gut?
All right, no need for that. You paint a vivid picture, Dane. He was headed to the White Coast to the southeast, Dover Fortress. He said it is where they train those religious fanatics, zealots. They pray all night instead of sleeping.
My thanks. And in return, wisdom. Too much beer-bibing will grow a fool in wit and words.
My thanks, Weaver of the Obvious. Now leave me to my unholy punishment.
The emissary made for Dover Fortress on the southeast coast. Be gentle if they spot me.
Yeah!
Yeah!
over. The emissary is somewhere here. Perhaps I can find the letter without bloodshed. The Bard Sert paladins trained at this fortress. This will not be an easy fight. Stretch your wings, Sunan. I must be careful now. Do you see? If I could steal the letter without killing the emissary, it would keep me out of trouble.
Carry the king's word that there's no hand to put it in.
Alfred's chosen elderman is a thane called Tetmund. The abbot Cunibert will want to know. I should meet Bassam and the abbot in Falkenstern.
Abbot who?
Eivor You have news?
Kent's new elderman will be Thane Tedmund.
Tedmund? Oh, the Lord is testing me. He is made mouse by you Danes. Barely leaves his fortress at Rusister. How might I gain his influence if he will not speak to me? Or to anyone? Tis a puzzle.
To inspire loyalty, Tedmund must owe you something, such as his life.
Go on.
A fortress stormed, a man kidnapped. If you beat back his enemy, saved him from sure death, his gratitude would...
swell. It would know no bounds. But that fortress will be harder to pry open than a nun's knees.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
Are you hiding something, Bassem?
There is a lumber mill nearby, correct?
Bemis Field. Alfred invests much in fortifying Wessex, and uses our forests to do so. The mill provides his wood.
Tedmund is there.
Impossible! How do you know?
I heard rumors that Tedmund had been lured out of self-exile to manage work on the fortifications of Canterbury.
Taking him from a lumberyard is less dangerous than assaulting a fortress. But your rescue attempt will not have the same flair. Is it worth it?
It may still work. Yes. Yes. Bring him to the megaliths.
And Fulke?
When I have Tedmund's fealty, you shall have Fulke. Now go. I will rustle up a small rescue party.
Do a roaring trade at Reculver and Tunbridge. I pay well for my catch.
The monks? Do those parchment skinned Christians ever eat meat?
Don't you believe in these bones?
I'm wary of this abbot, Bessem. He is self-serving and evasive. Can he really deliver Fulke?
The abbot is a friend of Fulke's. That is clear.
So long as he doesn't suspect our motive, we may have a chance.
Indeed. This brings to mind a story. Perhaps you've heard of it. The Scorpion and the Frog.
A children's story?
A cautionary tale. The Scorpion wants to cross the river, but he cannot swim. So he enlists the help of the Frog. The Frog agrees to carry him on his back, extracting a promise that the Scorpion will not sting him.
Let me guess. The Scorpion reneges, blaming his nature, and both drown.
The Scorpion crosses the river and stings an innocent man, killing him. So what does this tale tell us?
That your stories are clouded and their meaning doubly so?
It shows that every tale has 1,000 possible outcomes, many of which are surprising. If the abbot does not deliver Fulke, he will die at my hand. And we will continue our search.
A sobering approach.
Field is just ahead. Lead. I will follow.
I hope this chase will catch us a plump hen.
Once the abbot has Tedmund's gratitude,
best place I ever found him.
It will cost us nothing more than this.
If that leaden wit keeps his word.
You prefer to work in the shadows.
Get back to work! Time is coin and you're spending mine! Do you dare to question the orders of the great Thane Tedmund? I will have you flogged! Protect me!
What you did.
Stop caterwauling and you'll live.
Live? Oh, saints, protect me!
Silence will save you, Tedmund. Silence, not your saints.
In the name of Alfred, King of Wessex, I demand you release his royal subject into my care.
Come no closer, Christian, else your man dies by my blade.
Please, I'm not the man you want.
Keep your eye on this one. He'll be worth a hefty bounty.
Any false moves and I will snip your heels.
We have your man. Now let's finish this shadow play and be gone.
Are you sure that's Tedmund? He's dressed as a lord, but that man is shorter and fatter than I recall.
I'm not Tedmund. I'm not. I swear upon the holy rood, I am not Thane Tedmund.
What in heaven's name is happening here?
Who are you? Speak quickly, or I will slit your throat and leave you for the crows.
Shergar. I'm called Shergar. Lord Tedmund pays me a measly coin to serve as his double.
Brother Shergar, you are far from Augustine's priory.
I left the cloisters many moons ago, Your Holiness. The monastic life was not my calling.
We can use you yet, Shergar. Summon Tedmund to a meeting. Get him out in the open.
Tedmund has no care for me or what I have to say. My orders come by letter, never by mouth. I hardly know the man.
You're of no use to us, then. Perhaps I should just kill you here and now.
No, wait. Let me think. Let me think. Danes! To storm the walls, you need Danes. There's a raiding camp west of here I was told to be wary of. Acting as Tedmund, I ordered a band of soldiers to capture them. If you hurry, you may be able to stop this.
If another band of Danes wants to join our assault, we'll have the distraction we need to get inside Rucester.
If the Saxons don't slaughter them first...
I am still Tedmund to the men in the field. I could speak with their captain, send his men away.
It's a fearless plan.
The Nornir knit winding paths that cannot be unknotted. It seems Rucester was always in our path. Abbot, stay alert. We'll send word when we're ready to capture Tedmund.
And this fool? He knows much of our plan.
He'll come with us. And if he betrays me, I'll roast his balls over a roaring fire.
You will not regret this. My wily ways and quick wit will cease the need for bloodshed.
I still might kill you yet, man. if your prattling doesn't cease.
The rewards for being Tedmund are rapidly diminishing.
And how does one become a double? Are there vigorous challenges and tests to overcome?
I was born with the misfortune of looking like someone else. I should have stayed on God's chosen path.
What took you from it?
I'm the seventh son of a poor farmer. And not wanting another mouth to feed, my father gave me to the monks.
The cloistered life did not suit you?
I thought there would be great comfort in repetition. But instead I found nothing but prayer and back-breaking toil.
The Norns weave strange destinies. Now your life depends on the story you weave for yourself.
I'm not a good forgery. Still, tears bled in my hands, sweat, and I have a stutter when I'm nervous. But I will try.
Ah, the cornerstone of all great art.
The captain does not know Tedmund well. If we keep our heads, he will not question my orders. I hope.
We are too late. There is great horror here.
Those who remain must be saved, whatever the cost.
Let us approach the captain with caution. He drinks too much and does not need a reason to kill us. Yes, it is I, Thane Tedmund, coming to discuss the orders I gave to you not one day ago.
This hampock will get us all killed.
You murdered our people, men, women, children.
Fight down, you dogs! You're slaves of Kent now!
Say, Tedmund, what are you doing here?
How dare you address me in such a defiant manner? Do you not know who I am?
You are Tedmund, as I've said. And I mean no disrespect, Lord. But I was told you were back in Rucester.
Oh, yes. And do I look like I'm in Rucester?
You, do not, sir.
A wise man is always unexpected.
You travel in strange company, Lord. An Arab and a Dane.
I'm here to advise your Thane in the ways of my people.
That is correct. A cultural exchange of sorts. Perhaps one day I will visit your Daneland.
Norway. You mistake me for a foreigner. But are we not all just the measure of the places we've seen?
Right. Well, that aside, have you any further orders, Lord?
Yes. I order you to stop loitering and return to your barracks, you scabwit.
And what of the captured Danes?
You must kill them all! Every last... Sorry, no. Leave them here, tied up, as a feast for wolves and crows. That is all. You may depart. Shoo!
A convincing ruse that has earned you your freedom. Go, and make your life anew, not in another man's boots.
I will. This small sup of power has got me thinking. Perhaps I could be a leader of men. Yes! Hurry along, men! Warm thighs and ale awaits!
Come on!
Tied up like animals. I need to free them.
My thanks. Norns weave you well.
Come on, then!
We owe you our lives, friend. These Saxon whore sons would have killed us all.
Yes, they would have. And now's your chance to hit back. March with us on Rucester and drain it of riches.
I would gladly, friend. But we few will not break those iron-thick walls.
And we have no allies in Wessex. None who could be called upon to attack their countrymen.
Mercia will heed the call. Gidrich will provide our Viking a horde. We'll send a message to Oxenfordshire. The men of Mercia would gladly take a swipe at Wessex. What is your name, warrior?
Runa Egilsdottir.
We need ships, Runa.
We have a small fleet moored upriver, but a naval chain blocks passage to Rusister's walls.
I will remove it, and your people will bring their ships. Now, gather these fallen weapons and armor. Giedrich and the men of Oxenifordshire will need them to hide their Mercian origins.
My warriors were denied Valhalla today. I cannot bear the idea of gifting their weapons to more Saxons.
Their sacrifice was great. Their gift will be all the greater.
They will know justice with our victory. It will calm their restless shades, I promise. Will your men bring the armor to the battle?
And what is our plan?
In the morning, you will go to Buckingham, remind Giedrich of his promise. When you have his bond, meet me on the shore near Rusester with the ships.
Abbot Cunibert must be warned in advance. He'll need time to muster his rescue party.
Runa, that is your task. I will tell you where to meet him before you leave.
All seems in order. At first new light, I will leave.
Good. That gives us time to drink.
You've traveled so far to carry out your duty. Is this the life of a hidden one? Always on the move?
No. Mine is not the usual path. The Creed does travel. Our ideals are universal. We believe that.
So there's nowhere you call home?
No place I call home. No.
Weird.
For me, home is family. But I have no family.
No one? Not even Hytham?
Parents, brothers, all dead.
I lost my parents when I was 9 winters along. Without Sigurd, I would have...
There is always one unbreakable bond.
Yes.
Children. They bewilder you. They can cause you so much worry. Fill you with joy. Even stop your heart. And if you're lucky, they replace you. I was not so lucky. I had a son. I miss him terribly, even now.
I am sorry, Asim.
He was taken from me by someone I trusted, a friend, a mentor, a man who I would trust with anything.
Rusester will not be an easy nut to crack. Time to prepare.
Hya!
I should be cautious around here.
I need to clear this fort and break this chain to get our ships safely upriver. The mechanism should be inside. With the chain down, Gidrich and the ships can get through.
Eivor, we await your orders.
You brought your weapons and armor.
Aye, Raven Tamer.
Good. Now we dig in and wait for our friends. Well met, old friend.
When the chance arrived to lodge an axe in the sod of Wessex, you thought of me. Such an honor.
Is everything else in place, Eivor? Are we ready to take Rucester?
Rally our army. We will drag this mouse from his hole.
Yeah.
before me!
Then we will put them out.
See to it.
Is holed up in the tower keep. Press forward.
That's it.
Our way inside.
Before I let you take this fortress!
Winchester will not fall to your rabid pack of mongrels! Dane, Alfred's army will smear your innards across the battlements.
We're not here for stone and sand, Thane Tedmund.
I shit on you! You and your toy gods! I will not bow to you like some puppet's lord! I would rather die!
How much will your king pay us to keep your sniveling head upon your neck?
An army marches upon us from the south. A holy man from St. Hadrian's Priory, backed by a field.
Ah, then, Abbot Cynibert, God be praised. If riches are all you care about, the church has it in abundance.
If the terms are fair, you'll have your freedom. A chest or two of silver for a shit-stained sewer rat.
Stay quiet, or I'll not be able to stop my friend from slitting your throat.
Ah! Watch yourself, heathen. You handle me too roughly. You will die for the indignities you've showered upon me, Dane!
I mean no offense, Thane. You're only a hefty ransom to me, nothing more.
This is why you batter down my gates, kill my men for a purse of grubby coin? You have no honor!
Enough! I'll return you
You there! Heathens! Let this good man go, or suffer an iron sickness.
And what do you offer us in return?
Your lives?
We lost many good men storming this keep. It will not be in vain, Christ's slave. 20 chests of silver!
Give them all they ask, Cynibert. A hefty sum that will leave God's coffers hollow? I cannot give it up without some assurance. Tedmund, you extort me in return for my life? You were swiftly met, Abbot, not long after these scallious worms took my fort. On the Lord's bidding, Tedmund, at prayer, a terrible vision befell me. A host of heathens, your life in danger. A coincidence I find rather... rather ominous, Abbot. Do you... God help you, man. Are you well? Air! I need air!
He's dead.
The work of poison, no doubt.
No. Rouse the man! He cannot be dead! He must not be dead!
Poison? How does the man die of poison in our arms?
Many great kings and paranoids have carried poison in times of war, as an alternative to capture and ransom.
A catastrophe! Alfred will choose another and... By the saints! Alfred! How will I explain this to the king?
We followed this road to its end, Cynibert. You may not like where it led, but you owe us our half of the bargain.
You shall have your paladin. I need a day. Return to my abbey tomorrow, and you shall... oh dear.
These delays are grinding at my bones. We should abandon Cynibert. Find full care ourselves.
Peace, Eivor. Speak with Giedrich and relieve him of his oath. I'll meet you at Cynibert's abbey.
You fought like beasts, escaped from your hell today, Giedrich. Your oath to me is fulfilled.
It was good to stand shoulder to shoulder with you against the pox dogs of Wessex. May our friendship endure.
This tanglebriar of Christians and lords means nothing to me. I'm here for Sigurd.
I understand. When you find him again, come see me. We'll feast and sing, with mead and friendship to warm us.
Agreed. The brothers, or the abbot's men. I would say well met, brother, but I cannot shake off the needle itch of dread. Is something wrong?
I followed the abbot here, kept him in my sight. But the monks, his servants, I have seen nothing of them.
Dead?
I do not think so. But there is no good here in this grave hush.
And where is the abbot now?
In his quarters. Come, and be on your guard.
Does this have the stench of betrayal to you?
Why would the godly shepherd ally with the heretic?
Cunibert is a man who craves power and position. With Tedman dead, he must find it somewhere else.
There is truth in that. Keep your eyes and blade sharp.
Cunibert, your guests have arrived. Come. Supper's ready. The dear abbot sent me a warm invitation, said my friends were eager to meet with me. It's early for supper, I know. But Cunibert's ale goes so well with roasted lamb and cinnamon blueberry peas. I couldn't resist.
Where is my brother?
Is he not here? Mon Dieu, I never told him.
Kill her, and we'll never find Sigurd.
Sit, Eivor. Eat. And let me tell you the tale of a man who talks with gods.
You mock me. I've killed for much less.
Of course you have. Isn't that the way of this ugly world? We call the sheep and thin the flock as we see fit, you and I. Most who walk the earth are little more than talking blood bladders, wasted flesh. But not Sigurd. Sigurd is something else. Sigurd has been touched. He is deified. The gods, they speak through him.
You lured him in with that lie. Your words are bile and blight.
You should have listened, Eivor. I tried to tell you. The gods are real, and their power is within our grasp. You will never find him. Not till I have had my fill. To old friends. This really is delicious, Cunibert. Is it cloves I taste? Well. That concludes supper. Kill them, and bring their bodies to my sanctum in Canterbury.
They will be upon us soon. Maybe there is another way out.
Fulke let slip that her sanctum is at Canterbury.
She did. And with no cause. I'd approach the place with caution. It may be a lie.
It may be. But it's the only lead we have.
I hope all this innocent sacrifice is worth the trouble.
It's Sigurd. My brother. Of course it is.
Then come. Let us dive into the maw of death. I was never keen on seeing my winter years. This will not be for nothing, Eivor. We will find Sigurd.
It's not just him. I want Fulke to suffer.
This land of summer, mists, and forests, dreaming darkly. I see secrets, and I want to know England, all of it.
And yet it rounds on us at every turn, snarling like a cornered dog. I begin to despair of ever settling here.
Perhaps the stars write your path, and you will never have a home here.
Do you miss the land of your birth?
I have long been away, but it is fiercely beautiful beneath the vanity, arrogance and pettiness of men.
I should like to see it.
You could if you wish. My father was an architect, a builder of wonders. The Great Mosque of Samara, his masterpiece. Another man, who played the Caliphate's game better, took the credit. He was exiled, and died in poverty.
Your faith sours. What of loyalty? Shared stories round the hearth. Warm nights, bodies, and the tender love of another.
There are some who are worthy. A scant few, the tower above the sullied mass. Men and women of vision and valor.
Sigurd is one such man.
He is. Fulke isn't wrong on that score.
I fear for him, Basim. I cannot rest until he's safe.
Nor will I, my friend. The practice of learning has waned considerably in England since the days of the Romans. What books they still have, they keep locked away in their churches, hidden from the eyes of common folk.
Thralls and churls cannot read. What would be the point?
They could learn. The church could teach them. So much of human history would be open to them. Aristotle, Pythagoras, Euclid, ancient knowledge lost to all but a few hard-headed men of the cloth.
You have studied these works yourself?
In my youth, I was consumed with a passion for understanding. I spent many hours a day in the House of Wisdom in Baghdad.
A seminary?
A great library, full of the greatest learning of mankind. For a boy seeking answers, it holds many riches. One day, I was sitting cross-legged, devouring a study by the great astronomer Al-Khwarizmi. With the swiftness belying his years, the papers were plucked from my grasp by the great man himself. His presence stole my voice. He was kind and open-hearted. He showed me such scientific wonders.
What did you learn there?
Calendars and calculations placing the sun, moon, and five planets. Equations that crackled and sparkled with divine intelligence. I asked the great man, is this what it is to know God?
You saw your God's hand in the runes.
I found wisdom, and I have been searching for more ever since. There is great vastness outside ourselves, Eivor. Most only notice a few grains of sand. But some, like Sigurd, I believe.
You killed him! Die!
Only notice a few grains of sand. But some, like Sigurd, I believe, see the endless flow of the hourglass.
What you see in Sigurd, is this what Fulke sees as well?
I believe it is. find no friends in Canterbury, so try not to draw attention.
There's much here to admire, but it was built on God's gold while his people live in hovels.
This land of summer, mists, and forests, dreaming darkly. I see secrets, and I want to know England. All of it.
Espenyet, it rounds on us at every turn, snarling like a cornered dog. I begin to despair of ever settling here.
Perhaps the stars write your path, and you will never? This place swarms with Fulke's people. Sigurd will be well guarded. Caution and subtlety should be our path.
Ready? Follow me. I should not be seen in this area.
This is a trap.
She baits us. Cocksure and arrogant. But she cannot see failure in her path.
Her fearful wit would say otherwise.
Come, help me with this.
Whatever we find there, keep your head.
You chastise me like a child, Basim.
I guard you like a father. Nothing is served with your brutal end. You have much to do in this life. I know it.
More riddles, sly tongue.
No riddles. I sense a greatness within you both.
Hey!
Your destiny
can't do this
is
alone.
Not to stain the stones of this godhouse with your blood.
If she's still here, I will burn this Christ house to the ground.
For the order, for the glory of the ancients, to not let these infidels.
To arms, Basim!
So we are bundled like an ox.
This must be the way to Fulke's sanctum. What does it mean, these word tangles that speak of elves and demons?
Fulke! I'm here! Face me!
Have a care, Eivor. You will play into our hands.
Details on the Order of the Ancients. Fulke ranks high among them, but is not their head. By Odin, this is a sick tapestry she wove. For every drop of his blood she spilled, I will take a meat horn more. The Gospel of Mary Magdalene. The plans to the great fortress in Wessex. Is there something here we can use to breach it? Sigurd. Tell me that you found something.
Anything we can use!
I may have. A fortress in Sussex. The Order trained soldiers there.
We must be sure. Sigurd is running out of time. Anything else?
Documents of interest to the Hidden Ones. Heithen will surely want to look. But for Sigurd, Porchester is our only lead. If he is in Porchester Castle, we'll need a massive army to crack its walls.
I have many friends in England now. If I call on them, they will come.
They will.
Basim, she severed his arm clean off. Can a man survive such a loss?
Physically, he can. Mentally, it's hard to say. So much stress can drive a man to despair.
If you suggest he might take his own life as Tedman did, banish that idea. I must tell my people at the settlement that their Jarl remains a captive. They will not take it well.
We will not fail again, Eivor. I'll scout ahead and send word to the settlement when I know more of Porchester. Be ready.
Where is he? Where is Sigurd?
He is alive.
But not with you. Where is he?
Dag, not now. I need to speak with Randvi.
You never found him, did you? Tell us, Eivor! We deserve the truth!
I need to speak with Randvi. Step aside, now!
You never found him, because you didn't look! I see you, Eivor! I know what you are.
Eivor, you come alone. I fear what that means for Sigurd.
I could not find him. That madwoman Fulke, she slipped away, took him to Sussex. We need an army. Call on our alliances. Remind them of their oath to me. We must act before...
Before what, Eivor?
She tortured him, Randvi. Did unspeakable things. Severed his arm and left it as a gift. I fear she means to kill him. Slowly.
Gods.